students. Hello. Hello, Vanita.
Hey.
Yeah, connect quick. We'll start the class. Connect quick. Tell your friends. Yeah, I will tell your friends. Connect quick. Yeah. Hi, Ma.
Hi, sir. Good evening, sir.
Good evening. How are you, Ma?
Fine, sir. You, sir?
Yeah, fine. Be healthy. Don't go out from home.
No, sir. I'm not going.
Yeah. We'll start the class. Just wait for your friends, okay? Two of you are okay, there. Sir. Uh-huh. We'll wait for another 4-5 minutes, okay? Let everyone join. Okay, sir. You send a WhatsApp message to your friends, quick. Send a message.
Sir, I will do.
Yeah, quick.
Yes, sir, I will send.
We'll come. I will be in a line, okay? We'll do it.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Okay, sir. ನಾನು ಎಲ್ಲಾರ್ಗೂ ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಂತೆ ಇವಾಗ ಸರ್ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರಲ್ಲ ಕನೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬೇಕನ್ನ ಇಲ್ಲ ಬಿಜಿ ಇದ್ದಾಳೆ ನಾನು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಟಿವ್ ಸರ್ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ಯು ಕಾಲ್ ಅದರ್ಸ್
ಮಾಡಿ
ಪಪ್ಪ ನಿನಗೆ ಏನ್ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಲ್ಲ ಅಪ್ಪ
ಒಂದ್
ನಿಮಿಷ ಸರ್ ವೇಟ್ ಸರ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಇನ್
connected. Make audio free. Deepika. We'll start a lesson. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. May I know who is this? Name?
Yes.
Name? Hello. Who is this? Lenovo K8. Hello. Hello.
Ashok, sir. It's me, Ashok.
Good evening, Ashok. Yeah, we'll start.
Sir, good evening, sir.
Yeah, we'll wait another 2 minutes. Let everyone join, okay?
Okay, Ashok. Sir. Sure.
Yeah. Let another first let they join. Let 2 minutes we'll wait and we'll start with the lesson. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Just 2 minutes. Hello.
Yeah, sir. Okay.
I'll start with the lesson. Okay. Okay. Yeah, we'll start with the lesson. Coming to the module 2, yesterday I started, I think you have gone with an YouTube channel. There I have explained to you how an what is an important thing for on a module 2 which we have to study. And if you watch that in our department YouTube channel, it's already uploaded there as a chapter 2, part 1, part 2 and part 3. I've explained everything there, like link capacity and what is the goals of the module 2 and how that will be working, and what the link capacity will be there, and how the different links will work, and how different encoding techniques. I have taught you in a last class. Different encoding techniques question is very much important for exam also. That is NRZ L is there, NRZI, and Manchester is there, and coming to 4B and 5B. These things are very much important, which I have already explained you and uploaded in our YouTube channel, which you can see and you can ask me the questions. Now, coming to the next important thing in chapter 2, that is a framing. See, well, as I explained you about an OSI reference model, the 7 layers of a OSI reference model will be there. In that, a data link layer will be there. So what is this data link layer will do? It will collect all the bits from the physical layer, and it will construct it will aggregate all that frames, means bits, and it will construct a frame. So in this way, a frame will be constructed, and that frame will be sent to the next coming up the layer, that is a network layer. Now, host-to-host communication always done with the frame-to-frame. Means one frame will be sent from one system to the another system, which is connected to it. How a frame will be sent, then how a framing can be done, we'll discuss in this particular concept. As I told you in a previous classes and all, always our notes, whatever is there in between, assume source and destination. Our destination will be there somewhat, it is a far place. It will be there in a far place, and and later on, in between, we should connect with other nodes. Assume that my destination is far, and in between other nodes are there. The next node which is there, for that I must do the communication. This is important. Now, framing concept will comes with a system-to-system connection. That is a host-to-host connection with what medium you are going to be connected. Now here, whatever the zeros and ones you are sending, what your data link layer will do, it will collect all that bits and it will form that particular frame, and that frame will be exchanged from one system to the another system. Now observe this figure here, which I have shared. Observe carefully. Node A and node B, two systems are there, right? And this node A system is having one adapter, and a node B system is having a adapter is there. What do you mean by this adapter? Adapter is a port where it will be open to connect to the other system, like your Ethernet port. If you observe your any devices, Ethernet port or any other one port will be there, from where we are going to connect to the other system. Now, in between, whether it is a wireless medium or a wired medium, in between one medium will be there. For example, in our mobiles and all, we will consider our antenna as a receiver and a transmitter adapter. Like that, always an adapter will be there in between. Now, what happens, the next thing is, when node A wishes to transmit a frame to node B, first what it will do, it will take its adapter, be ready, I am sending an to you. What adapter will do? Adapter will collect all that bits and it will make a frame, and it will sends to the link. What the other node, B node, will do? B node will collect all that sequence of bits. One by one bit will come, zeros and one, zero and one. It will come, it will collect one by one, one by one. It will collect all the bits. It will keep in a memory. Once it will come, or that frame is came, then automatically from a temporary memory buffer it will take and it will tells yes, one frame is came, and it will do the work. If you see my YouTube classes, previous classes, if you have seen already, there I have told very clearly that data link layer, it will checks, it will detects for errors also. That is a bit errors and bit error correction also it will detect. There what after coming a frame, what it will do, it will checks for any errors is there in this particular thing. That is any bit errors is there, it will detect. If error is there, it will discard that and it will tell I need a retransmission of that. Recognizing exactly what set of bits constitute a frame, that is determining where the frame begins and ends. This is very much important here. That is, for example, I will tell you myself, if someone is giving me some data, zeros and ones, I know where is the starting point and where is the ending point. Why? Because I am a human being and my opposite person will tell that much. But a system is in a unit. Always I used to keep you telling like this. Now, what happens, system, how it will recognize the zeros and ones are coming sequentially, how it will recognize the starting point and ending point of an a frame. This is very important. Recognizing the starting and ending to a frame, then how frame will be taken to the memory. Here, in this particular, framing will be done in a three method. The framing will be done in a three methods. Now, I will back with this video. Now you can see here. Now you can see. I will show you the things. One, you can see here. Are you seeing here? Can you see this? Can you see this? Hello? Right? Still, I'm bringing nearer to you. Okay? Yeah? Just I'll back here. Want here, just 1 minute. Yeah, now you can see here, right? I'm audible to you. Can you see this? Can you see this? Can you see this book? What I have written? Huh?
Sir, it's not visible.
Now? Now?
No, sir.
Now? Okay, pa. See, and I will explain you the things. A data framing using an a starting size of a frame. Listen here. What I have written here, I will explain you. I have written a boxes like this here, right? And the starting box, assume this is one frame sequence is there here. And here actually, what I am doing, the first bit always represents the size of that particular coming frame. This is one particular method.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. See, what is the first bit I have written here is 5. What do you mean by this? Including the head bit, 5 bits here afterwards will be the size of that particular frame. That means 1, 2, 3, 4. Are you observing? Including the
yes, 5
bits. So that means the size of the frame will be up to 4. Now you see, again 7 is there, observing. Again 7 here, 7 is there here. And this 7 indicates next, once 4 is over, this 7 indicates the head bit size. Now from here afterwards, including this, 7 bits will be the size of that particular frame. Now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, including this, it will become a 7. Now when it comes to the receiver side, observe carefully here. When it comes to the receiver side, what receiver will do, this 5 whatever will be there, it will discard the first bit and thereafterwards it will take as a data 1, 2, 3, 4. Why? Because 5 is also a 1 bit, correct? No. So 5 bit. Coming to the next bit, so it will take 7. Now 7 will become a 8. Why? Because already 5 bits over according to the first bit size. Now it will comes to the 7. 7 will become automatically the header bit. Now this will take this particular, means take out this particular bit. Here afterwards, will be there. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 7 bits. In this way, if everything goes correctly, it is correct. But what is the disadvantage in this particular thing? What is the disadvantage here? Observe carefully. If bit 4 missed, assume. while coming to the receiver, assume that the bit 4 is missed due to the noise or due to something, due to the transmission error, the bit 4 has been missed, assume. Sometimes it will happen in a real world, correct? No? Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, so sir. It will happen in a real world. Now, assume that if that happens, what happens here? Observe carefully now. Observe carefully. 5 is the starting 8 bit. 1, 2, 3, 4 is missing. 7, it will count as another bit. According to the sender, 7 is the size of the next header. But it has been missed. Header. So because of that, entire frame sequence will go wrong. So this is the disadvantage in this size framing technique. Because of this, this size framing technique will fail. Right. Coming to the next method of this particular thing, that is framing with the byte stuffing. What is this framing with byte stuffing? Very simple. This is a very simple technique, I'll tell you. The reserve characters will be added at the starting and the ending of the frame. For example, what is the reserve characters it will add? We will consider like this. So my frame or my technology will consider STX and ETX as a starting and a ending tags. Means my opponent, whoever is there, the receiver, whoever is there, if we see first STX, then he will think, yes, starting of the frame has been started. He will remove that STX. Afterwards, whatever will come, he will consider as a data. He encounters ETX. Once ETX characters encountered, then he will think that, okay, this ends the frame. So whatever is there between STX and ETX, that is an data. So in this way, observe now, here with a clean example I have written here, assume, starting tag will be STX. Starting tag will be STX. Ending tag will be. Now, assume the message we want to send is this is a cat. If you want to send a message, this is a cat, sender STX adding. This is an indication that the frame has been started. Sender will add STX at the beginning. This is a cat is a data. After this, the frame ends, ETX will be added. And this data will be sent to the receiver. Then what receiver will do? First, receiver checks for a STX characters. He removes the STX characters. Afterwards, everything is data. He will start keeping that in a memory or a buffer. Receiver will take T, H, I, S, like this, space, one by one thing he will take. So this is a cat, he will take. Afterwards, the receiver will take E, T, X. Then the receiver automatically, once he encounters the ETX, the receiver will stop. Then automatically, this is a cat will be treated as one particular frame. Right?
Well, okay,
now, what is the disadvantage in this particular thing? Assume, in our data, once the ETX encounters, the receiver considers the data as one frame, and this is a cat will be stored in a memory. What is the disadvantage here? Again, I'll show here. You can see. If message is having STX or ETX, what we can do? You can ask me the question, sir. Assume that my message, I'm having a STX. My cat name is STX. So I want to tell this is a STX cat. Are you getting? If I want to tell like that, what happens? STX I'm using for a tag. Then how my receiver will identify whether it's a starting or whether it's data? The receiver gets confusion. So now you observe here, you observe carefully here, message is there, this is a STX cat, okay? This is a STX cat. Now what sender will do, as usual, assume that sender doesn't have any idea what is the problem here. STX he will fix the starting, ETX will fix at the end. So, STX cat, this is a
STX.
Please don't disturb. Audio you disable. Yeah. Now you see this. Now you see this. In between STX, how it makes a problem. This is very much important. That is, now where is the starting point of this entire frame? The receiver will get a doubt. Now you can observe here. The receiver will get a doubt, confused that. Where is STX? First, he will see this is STX and next data will start. Now again STX will come, whatever is there here, this he will miss receiver will discard entire thing and entire data will be lost here. What receiver will do? In a memory, will keep only cat. Why? Because here another STX came in between. So this is a major problem in a byte stuffing. For this, to solve this particular problem, what the technology they will do, wherever the data is there as a STX or ED tags, reserved tags, before that, escape character will be placed. This is very much important in exam. They will give you that. Consider the following data. Explain the byte stuffing with an example. This is a definite question will be there. So because of that, I am explaining clearly here. So between put an escape character. So how a escape character? Assume your next sender STX. This is a slash STX cat. Now this slash indicates that at the receiver side, the slash indicates that you don't consider this STX. Now this STX will become an ordinary data. That means we are escaping the reservedness or starting tagness of that particular thing using a slash. Getting any doubt here? Cleared? Yeah, so we'll go to the next method, that is framing with a bit stuffing. Framing with a bit stuffing will do like this always, that is, a bit stuffing will be there. Instead of considering a characters here, we'll consider a data in a form of an bits. What do you mean by here? For example, I will consider a data as like this, 10110101. Assume this is my data. I repeat, 10110101 is my data. So always data will be identified with the starting and ending frame tags. Here, what is the starting and ending frame tags? This is very much important. The starting and ending frame tags means 0. I repeat, 0, 6, 1, 0, 6, 1, 0 is a tag. Here, bit stuffing tag is a reserved tag which will be used in all the protocols, that is host level protocols like HDLC, PPP, CASM network. In all these network today also using this particular technique. What do you mean by this? The flag will be there between the starting and ending of an data. That is, observe carefully now here. I'm writing here. The starting will be done with 0, 6, 1s and 0. And ending will be there always with 0, 6, 1s, 6, 1s and a 0. Now, how a receiver side, this data will be sent to the receiver. The receiver, what he will do? First, he will always what receiver will do? First, 0, 6, 1, 0. He will count. Yeah, this is a starting tag. He will remove that. Receiver will remove that. Then whatever bits comes next will be the data. He will keep on taking that particular data. That is 10101101 will be taken. Next, what happens again? 0, 6, 1s and 0 will come. Once again, this tag will come. The receiver will stops that. Yes, one frame has been came. This is the one frame. He will store that frame in a memory. Now, your question arises. Sir, if my data will have like this 6 ones, whatever is there, more ones is there like that. More than 6 ones is there after a 0. Then how it will be treated? Correct? No. Same thing. Same tag can be there in my data sequence also. Then how it will be identified? Here, we are going to use, observe carefully, here we are going to use bit stuffing. We will call this as a bit stuffing. What do you mean by bit stuffing? Bit stuffing, very clearly I will tell you, what is called a bit stuffing, wherever 5 ones will come, after 5 ones, 10 bit will be added in a data at a sender side. Underline this point, at a sender side, wherever 5 ones, more than 5 ones will come, after 5th one, a 0 will be added. For example, assume, now I'll repeat. assume that my data is 101011111110111. Assume this is my data. Are you getting? Now here 6 ones are there. How the sender will do the bit stuffing? Observe carefully. 1 0 1 0. Why? Because you are single ones. Observe now. 1 1 time, 1 second time, 1 third time, 1 fourth time, 1 fifth time. 5th one's over, then it will add 1 0 here. If you're not seeing, everyone seeing, I think, right? It will add a 0 here. Now after a 5th one is there, then another 2 ones is there, it will add 1 1. Again, 0. Whatever data is there, like that, it will put. That means, observe carefully, this bit is called as a stuffing bit. Why we'll call this as a stuffing bit? If more than 5 ones is there, 0 will be added there. Correct? No? Same algorithm will be told to the receiver. Assume that this data will go to the receiver side. Here, receiver is there. Data will go to the receiver side. What receiver will do? He will take one by one bit. It is 1 0 1 0 1. Observe now. First one, second one, third one, fourth one, fifth one. Afterwards, 0 is there. He will discard that 0. Who will discard? At the receiver side, the stuffing bit has been discarded. After discarding, it will take 1 1 0 1 1 1. Now this is the data taken at a receiver side. So this problem of 7 marks will be in a question definitely. Everyone getting what I'm telling you? Any doubts?
Yeah.
Any doubts? Now you come to the audio. Any doubts? Are you getting now what I'm telling you? Right? So,
yes, sir.
This is a bit stuffing which will be done. So, wherever more than five ones will be there, after the 5th one, the 0 bit will be added. This is called
added
stuffing. In this way, the framing will be done in a data link layer. And after doing this frame, the frame will be sent to the receiver. And the receiver, the receiver will receive and he will do the framing according to the starting and ending points, how different methods I have shown you. Using of that particular methods, the receiver will identify the frame and it will store the frame in. Now this session we'll keep as a trial one for the framing topic today, and tomorrow onwards in a regular 5:30 tomorrow onwards CN class will be there with examples. Everything I will do, please cooperate, come in online, we'll discuss there and we'll do the further things. Today, because of less members, I think only 15 participants are there. Because of that, I can't do with that. Why? Because this is very important for exam. So because of that, next topic, we are going for an error detecting methods. Error detecting methods is very much important, where we are discussing the parity bit checking examples and CRC problem we will do, and where later on we'll go for an humming code. Humming code is a lab program for you. Correct? No?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. How many of you already seen the YouTube videos from beginning I have done? Everyone? You watched that videos? Hello?
Only one, sir.
You have to watch the videos, previous videos you watch, otherwise you can't understand these topics. Why? Because all I have did, whatever the previous thing I have did, OSI reference model, it is for 10 marks question for you. Okay. Thank you.
Hello. Okay, sir. Okay.
Thank you.
Yes.
We'll go in a next
thank
class.
You. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Be safe, sir.
Okay, ma. Be safe, everyone.
Okay, sir.